performance optimizations in ClickHouse. So how do I see performance optimizations? It looks like this game. Did you play this game? Do you familiar with this game? I did not. But I feel that this game looks like very similar to performance optimizations. It is the game when you need to smash some rats with a hammer. So how do I perform performance optimization? I just run and profile my code on multiple different workloads. Look at the profile and optimize everything that stands out. Just smash. Smash everything. And I will tell you a little about some of these optimizations. First, the question, what table engine is faster? What is more efficient? Merge tree or memory? We have multiple table engines in ClickHouse, and merge tree store data on disk, and memory tables store data in memory. And memory, as we know, is faster than disk most of the time. So can we make the conclusion that memory tables are faster than merge tree? By the way, what does it mean faster? If memory is faster than disk, what do we consider? Sequential read or write, throughput, or latencies of random read or writes, or some number of read or write operations under specific parallelism and workload. There are multiple senses of what is fast. In some cases, memory can be slower than disks if you use single channel memory and very performant disk subsystem like 10 NVMe SSD. But if you have this system, it is very unbalanced and disks cannot outperform memory. So let's do an experiment. I have a table in ClickHouse. I execute a query from merge tree table. It takes 57 milliseconds. 57. I will try to experiment with memory table. I created memory table. I insert data into it. The data is inserted. Let's try the query. Now it is just 50 milliseconds, 54. And from merge tree, it is 57, 65. From memory, it is 48, 49. So memory tables are faster than merge tree. No surprise. But actually, it is more complicated. So merge tree tables store data on disk. It's not quite on disk. It is actually in file system. File system has page cache. Page cache is in memory. So when we read data from file system, actually it can be read from memory. Exactly the same as for memory tables. So we can make another conclusion that there should be no difference between memory and merge tree tables if data is in page cache. But in previous example, in our experiment, we see that merge tree was slower than memory. So why it is slower? First, let's look at some obvious cases when merge tree can be faster than memory. First case is just the primary key. So merge tree table can have primary key, and it allows to read sub-ranges of data. Memory tables always do full scan. This is obvious reason, but it is not interesting. The question is it possible that merge tree is faster than memory even when we do full scan? Let's do another experiment. I prepared some more complicated query. From merge tree, it is 171 milliseconds. From memory, it is 200 milliseconds. So again, merge tree is faster than memory. Merge tree, 159 milliseconds. Memory is 200 milliseconds. But I just said it incorrectly. Now memory somehow appeared to be slower than merge tree. Let's look at this video again. I have this query with substring search and regular expressions from hits table. It was 170 milliseconds. From memory table, 200 milliseconds. Now I use ClickHouse benchmark tool to check the performance. So in this example, memory is slower than merge tree. But why? How it is possible? Let's look at some less obvious cases. How merge tree can be faster than memory? Merge tree tables store data in sorted order, sorted by primary key. It not only allows to read sub-ranges of data, it also, even if you do full scan and read all data, it allows to use data locality in algorithms. For example, when we do group by and we met one key twice in consecutive records or more than one time, we don't perform excessive lookup in hash table. So we use data locality. This is another possible reason. But what if data in merge tree and memory actually is stored in the same order? What if you have identical data, identical order, and we read all this data from merge tree and from memory? Is it possible that merge tree will be still faster than memory? To answer this question, we have to dig into the way how ClickHouse processes the data. ClickHouse is column-oriented system. Data is stored by columns. But also data in memory is processed by columns. It is columnar both on disk and in memory. It is quite easy, and you may be already familiar. I can show it in examples of array of structures and structure of arrays. When you write your program and you have some object like point with multiple fields, you can wrap it in a structure and this and create array of this object. It is array of structures. Another approach is named structure of arrays. You create a structure, but with array for every field. So ClickHouse does basically this, but actually slightly more complicated. It not just store every column in one huge array. It splits data by chunks. Chunks should be not too big and not too small, like a few tenths of thousands of values. So we have chunks of arrays for every column. And we have array of these chunks. Sometimes it is named Morsel-based processing. Morsel, it is this confusing English word that I read in some scientific paper. I don't like this word. I would like if you name it just ClickHouse-based processing. ClickHouse-based processing is more understandable. Then we have to figure out how exactly do ClickHouse read the data from table. First, let's look at merge tree table. We need to do the following steps. Read compressed data from file system. Data is compressed. Before decompression, we need to calculate and validate checksums because we checksum all our data. Then we need to decompress this data. After we decompress, we need to deserialize decompressed data into chunks of columns. And only when we have chunks of columns in memory, we can process them. If we compare to memory tables, it will be much more simple. Memory tables contain already prepared chunks of columns. We just need to do nothing. They are ready to be processed. So, merge tree tables are this complicated. Memory tables are very simple. And again, we have a question. How it is possible that merge tree tables are still faster than memory? We need to go deeper. What exactly happens when we read data? In case of merge tree, how to read data from file system? We can use synchronous I/O like read, eread, syscall, or mmap. We can use asynchronous I/O like uring or AIO. If we use synchronous I/O, we can use page cache or we can bypass page cache with all direct option. If we read with simple read syscall and data is in page cache, it will be copied from page cache to user space. I don't like copying my data around. I don't like excessive copying. But if we read compressed data, and if it is well compressed, say 10 times, we will do very little amount of time reading data. We will spend most of the time decompressing data and processing data. So if data is compressed, if it compressed quite well, we don't spend much time reading it. Next step. We have to decompress our data. In ClickHouse, we use LZ4 by default. You can use more heavy algorithm like ZSTD, or you can turn off compression and specify none method. Sometimes when you turn off compression, queries will be processing slower than LZ4. But why they will be slower? I will explain it later. Another question is about compressed block size. When we compress data, should we collect 1 megabyte blocks or 64 kilobytes? What is better? What is better for performance? It is also unclear. Let's go even deeper. How to deserialize data? After we decompress data, how to deserialize it and place into column? In ClickHouse, there is almost no deserialization at all. We just copy our data. We have decompressed block. We select some sub-range of data and copy into column. But why do we need to copy data at all? I will answer this question. So let's summarize the difference. In memory tables, we have already prepared chunks in memory. In merge tree, chunks of columns are formatted dynamically during read, and we do more work for merge tree. Is it even possible if we do more work, but it appears to be more efficient? And how it is possible? The answer is yes. It is obviously possible to process queries more efficiently when doing more work. If we do more work only to do next part of our work in some more optimal way. So we spend more time at the start and spend less time during all the rest, query processing time. Sounds very easy, and actually it is not even smart. So in case of merge tree, chunks of columns can be formatted dynamically. And in memory, chunks of columns are very rigid. Suppose you have a table And in this table, you have one very small column, like city identifier, uint something, and one very big column like URL or page content. City will be 4 bytes per record. Page content will be 100 kilobytes per record. When we have block of data, it contains fixed number of records, say 1,000 of records. And city column will be 4 kilobytes. And content column will be 400 megabytes. And if we read the content column, it will not fit in a CPU cache. It will be much better to have smaller chunks of data to process queries using content column. But if we only use city column, it will be much better to have large chunks of data. And in memory tables, the size of chunk is fixed. We cannot change it. For merge tree tables, we can process one query and create smaller chunks of data in memory for better cache locality. For merge tree, and if we have large columns in another query, we will create small, smaller temporary chunks, because large chunks will not fit in CPU cache. So what is cache locality? To answer this question, we have to check what is the speed of the main memory. Actually, the question is, what memory do we have? On what server? Or is it server or workstation? Or is it laptop? By the way, do anyone of you actually aware of what is the memory speed on your laptop? Do you ever ask yourself this question? Most of you probably not. But for me, it is very important. I know that on my workstation, memory speed is about 20 and something gigabytes per second. And it is not very large, not very good, because I have single channel memory. Or maybe two channel memory, I don't remember. But on servers, the number of memory channels go up to 8. With 8 memory channels, the throughput of the main memory can be more than 100 gigabytes per second, but still less than 200 gigabytes per second. The next question is about CPU cache. What is the speed of CPU cache? And you have to know that CPU has multiple levels of cache hierarchy. Most of the contemporary server CPUs have three-level caching, 1, 2, and 3. And another question is the speed of CPU cache of single CPU core or multiple cores altogether. Because level 1 CPU cache is per core. Level 3 CPU cache is per socket. On your server, you can have two sockets, and every socket can have up to 64 CPU cores, probably with hyper threading. And the speed of CPU cache, especially level 1, can be multiple hundreds of gigabytes per second. And of course, it is faster than memory, faster than main memory. Another question is, what speed do we measure? I told about throughput, but what about latency? The latency of cache is also obviously better than memory. So if data is in a CPU cache, that is actually quite small. Level 3 CPU cache is up to tens of megabytes in total. Level 1 of CPU cache for data is as small as 32 kilobytes. Just 32 kilobytes. But if data is in level 1 cache, it is much better for basically everything. And to review the cache locality more deeply, let's look at another example. So, ClickHouse always compresses data by default. Data is compressed when it is written, inserted, and decompressed when it is read. It is decompressed on select. If you try to profile some queries, you will notice that you always have LZ4 decompress save function in top by CPU usage. So after profiling, you may want to say that maybe it will be better to just turn off compression. Turn off compression and everything will be just more fast. Is that true? No, it isn't. To explain, I will tell you a story. Once upon a time, one stranger came to me in Telegram with a question. I have very fast I/O subsystem, but my queries is limited by CPU. I profiled these queries, and they are limited by decompression. Is it possible to turn off decompression? And I answered, no, it is not possible. Data in ClickHouse is always compressed. You cannot turn compression off. And he asked me, but maybe I can edit the code and make an option to turn off decompression. And I said, sure, send me a pull request. You will become a ClickHouse contributor. You will be very proud of yourself to be a ClickHouse contributor. Just send me a pull request and I will help you to merge it. In the next day, there will be a pull request with implementation of compression method none. So no compression. I made a review, I merged it. This guy became a ClickHouse contributor and he became very proud of it. So task solved. But I was wondering and asked him, so what is the benefit? What is the improvement of your queries? And he answered, sorry, I cannot test the improvement because I turned off compression and now data does not fit on my SSD. I cannot use this option at all. So don't turn compression because you will have too much data. Compression is very useful. There are multiple reasons why you don't want to turn off compression. First, when you turn off compression, data will not fit on disk. Easy. It's very simple reason. Second possible reason, you turn it off compression, but now ClickHouse has to read more data from disk. And data reading will be limited by disk performance. Also, very simple reason. And third reason, you turn it off compression, data fits on disk, but less amount of data can be cached in memory. Because compressed data is cached in memory. If you turn it off compression, now it is decompressed data that has to be cached in memory. And you just use your memory less efficient. But that's not all the reasons. Another question. If you have a huge amount of memory, terabytes of memory, I don't know how large amount of memory do you have on your server? Maybe 1 terabyte. Maybe someone have huge servers with 8 terabytes of memory. If data fits in memory completely, even without compression, does it make sense to turn off compression? Or does it make sense to compress the data in memory? If all these reasons are irrelevant, and you have tons of memory, answering this question is not so easy. Let's try to do it. When your data is uncompressed, you don't have to decompress it, but sometimes you still have to copy it. And memcopy function can be used as comparison with compression algorithms. It can be imagined as the most weak possible compression. When you compress or decompress data, you take compressed data and just decompress to some another location. Memory copy will just copy data around from one location to another. So memcopy is obviously the fastest example of so-called compression algorithm. And we need to compare the performance. Memcopy is about 12 gigabytes per second on typical server with typical implementation. LZ4 decompression is about, it depends on data distribution. It is about from 2 to 4 gigabytes per second of decompressed data. So we just proven that memcopy is faster than LZ4 decompression. But something is not so easy. Can we just make a conclusion that if you will not compress your data in memory, it will be faster? Because memcopy is faster than LZ4 decompression. But don't go straight to the conclusions. We need to remind let's look at the following scenario. We need to remind everything. What I thought about cache locality, what I thought about memory speed, CPU cores. So this scenario, data is stored in memory completely. Data is processed by chunks of columns. Every chunk is small enough, and individually, every chunk fits in CPU cache. Processing of every chunk, like take two columns, perform sum, or aggregate data. Processing of every chunk also fits in CPU cache by temporary data. And data is processed by multiple threads. So we read huge amount of data from main memory. Maybe terabytes. These terabytes are in small chunks. Every chunk fits in CPU cache, like 20 kilobytes. All temporary data also fits in CPU cache. And data is processed by multiple threads. So let's compare the performance of memory copy and LZ4 decompression again, but from multiple threads. On my machine, I have a Ryzen CPU with 16 cores. If every CPU core will do memory copy, we can do simple arithmetic. 12 gigabytes per second multiplied by 16 cores, it will be 192 gigabytes per second. It is a straight calculation, maybe unrealistic. If we do LZ4 decompression, it will be 2 to 4 gigabytes per second multiplied by 16 cores. It will give 32 to 48 gigabytes per second of decompressed data. But memory read throughput on my machine is below 30 gigabytes per second. So I cannot do memory copy with the speed of 192 gigabytes per second. It will be limited by memory throughput. And LZ4 decompression will be also limited by memory throughput. So there will be no difference between memory copy and LZ4 decompression. But not that simple. When we do LZ4 decompression, we read compressed data from memory. And we decompress data to temporary blocks that fit in CPU cache. After processing, we discard these blocks. So decompressed data never touching the main memory. We only read compressed data from main memory. And compressed data is not 32, 48 gigabytes per second, it is, say, 10 times less, just 3 gigabytes per second. So actually, LZ4 decompression is not limited by memory speed. And as we read less amount of data from memory, we use memory throughput just more efficiently. And LZ4 decompression can be faster than memory copy. So we can say that memory is the new disk. When we tell about speeds, like 100 gigabytes per second, it will be limited by memory. And cache is faster than memory, so looks like memory is just a new disk. Imagine that you read data from disk. It is very fast disk, but it's still slower than CPU cache. So LZ4 decompression can be actually faster than memory copy. It was an example from my machine. Let's look at the server. One of the most powerful two-socket servers that you can get. With AMD EPYC CPU, 128 cores in total, 256 hyper-threading cores, and 8-channel memory, with maximum throughput of 190 gigabytes per second, according to the specs. And if we do calculation, LZ4 decompression will be faster even on this machine, because if you multiply 2 gigabytes per second by 128 cores, it will be 256 gigabytes per second. Just awesome. Ridiculous speed. And we will read less amount of memory, less amount of data from memory, so we can actually process data at this ridiculous speed. But if we don't have 128 cores, it is not so obvious. Maybe LZ4 decompression will be still limited by limited by CPU and will be slower than memory copy. But if it is limited by CPU, there is potential to optimize it. It will be very hard, but maybe I can optimize LZ4. And by the way, I have a presentation and I have an article about how I did optimize LZ4. If you will have time, I invite you to read this article. So, actually, memory tables can be slower than merge tree, because merge tree first compresses the data, and memory tables are not compressing the data, and merge tree tables create data chunks dynamically, and data chunks can fit in CPU cache. Memory tables have predefined fixed size chunks in memory. They cannot be adjusted dynamically to the query. So these are the reasons why merge tree tables can be sometimes faster. But I made some optimizations for memory tables. I noticed that block size on insertion is not optimal. I just lowered the block size. Here is the pull request. I have added support for compression in memory tables. So they should be better due to memory speed, as I explained. I also have made some optimizations for merge tree tables. I removed unnecessarily copying if no compression is selected. I introduced a setting to turn off checksums. It did not help, and you should not turn off checksums. Be on the safe side. Stay safe with checksums. It does not hurt performance. I can explain why it does not hurt performance, but I don't have time, so another optimization. I implemented a setting to read data with mmap to avoid unnecessarily copying from page cache to memory, to user space. And also to avoid mmap and munmap frequently, I added a cache of memory mappings. So let's do an experiment, final experiment. I run ClickHouse client. I made a query from merge tree table, 180 milliseconds. I do the same from memory table, 200 milliseconds. Memory is slower. I will apply my optimization. I create memory table with setting compress equals to 1. Now I will insert data into memory table. Data is inserted more slowly because it is compressing. Now data is compressing and it is stored in memory compressed. So I execute my query, it is 300 milliseconds. What? It is slower. Actually, it is slower. It was 200 milliseconds for memory. Without compression, I compressed my data. It is 300 milliseconds. So I made support for compression of memory tables to optimize my queries. I optimized everything, but queries turn out to be slower. All my theory is just wrong. What a pity. But don't give up. There is one small detail that I forgot. What I forgot? I forgot to tune block size. Now, before filling my memory table, I will set block size to just 8,000. I will insert my data. By default, block size is 64K. Now just 8K. I made it smaller. And I check my query. What will be the performance? The old table memory was a merge tree was 188 memory, new table 100 milliseconds, 98 milliseconds. Let's stop here. Now it is faster for real. It was 160 and now it is 98, much faster. So actually I managed to optimize everything. So I hope you followed me. Let's go to the conclusions. If you want to optimize performance of your code, you just need to know everything that your code is actually doing, to profile your code on realistic workloads, not just synthetic data, to know your hardware, to be aware of capabilities and numbers, memory throughput, memory latencies, cache latencies, whatever. And don't forget that CPU has multiple cores, it has cache, and actually multiple caches. Don't mess up and confuse latency with throughput. So easy. And please, optimize your code. Write fast code. Become a ClickHouse contributor. You will be lucky. And you will be proud of being a ClickHouse contributor. Thank you.